السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. So we are discussing Hadith number 33 and 34 under the headline باب علامة المنافق in كتاب الإيمان of صحيح البخاري. صحيح البخاري كتاب الإيمان باب علامة المنافق. علامة المنافق means the signs of a hypocrite. The signs of the hypocrites, منافقين. Okay. Under that باب, two hadiths are there. So we are discussing the Fath al-Bari. It continues. So we shall repeat the hadith once more. Hadith 33. An Abi Huraira. عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال آية المنافق ثلاث إذا حدث كذب وإذا وعد أخلف وإذا اؤتمن خان. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه, the famous companion of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, reports this hadith from Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال, he said, that is Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said آية المنافق, the sign of hypocrites, the signs of hypocrite. Thalath, they are three in number. Idha haddatha, whenever he tells, he speaks, kadhaba, he tells a lie. So whenever he speaks, he tells a lie. Lie. Wa idha wa'ada, and whenever he promises, akhlafa, he used to break it. He'll break it. وَإِذَا أُتُمِنَا, and whenever he is entrusted with an amanat, whenever he is given an amanat, then khana, he'll be cheating. He'll be proving to be treacherous. Now, the next hadith, 34. An Abdullah ibn Amr, an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قال, أَرْبَعٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ كَانَ مُنَافِقًا خَالِصًا. If there are four features, four characteristic features in you or in one person, then he will be a pure hypocrite. Munafiq khalis. That means a pure hypocrite. وَمَنْ كَانَتْ فِيهِ خَصْلَةٌ مِّنْهُنَّا. And if there is any one of these four characteristic features in one person, then كانت فيه خصلة من النفاق. Then we can say there is one feature of a munafiq in that person. حتى يدعها, till he abandons or gives it. Okay. إذا اتمنى خانا, and those four features are إذا اتمنى خانا, whenever he is entrusted, he will be proving treacherous. وَإِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبَ, and whenever he speaks, he used to tell lie. He will tell lie. Then, وَإِذَا عَاهَدَ غَدَرَ, whenever he is in a covenant, in a treaty with others, غَدَرَ, he will be proving treacherous. He will be cheating. وَإِذَا خَاصَمَ, and whenever he quarrels, فَجَرَ, he will be behaving in an imprudent manner, or in an imprudent manner, or he'll be using insulting words. He'll be behaving in an insulting manner. He'll be using abusive words like that. Okay. Now, the Fath al-Bari continues. The explanatory notes from Fath al-Bari. We see. قوله آية المنافق ثلاث. الآية العلامة. Here, آية المنافق, the sign of hypocrite. ثلاث. Three. So, آية here means what? علامة. That means علامة. Sign. Yes. وإفراد الآية إما على إرادة الجنس أو أن العلامة إنما تحصل باجتماع الثلاث. So here ayat is mentioned as in singular form. Ifrad means singular. So here ayat is in singular form. Ayat means alamat. Ayat in singular form. Ayat plural form. So here the title is given as, or the words are given as ayatul munafiqi, not ayatul munafiqi. So singular form is used. Why? Ala imma ala aradatil jins. Either it is to denote the jins or the category, the species of the genus of this munafiq or alamat, the signs of hypocrite. Oh, or annal alamata, certainly the alamat or the sign of a hypocrite. Innama tahsilu, it will be reached bijtima'i thalathi, by assembling these three features. So the assembling, by combining the three features, the alamat, the signs of hypocrite will be reaching. Either in that sense, or it may be used, it is used, or the singular form is used to denote the jinns as a common noun. Okay, then. فَإِنْ قِيلَ ظَاهِرْهُ الْحَصْرُ فِي الثَّلَاثِ فَكَيْفَ جَاءَ فِي الْحَدِيثِ الْآخِرِ بِلَفْلِ أَرْبَعٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ الْحَدِيثِ. So, in the first hadith we see there are three features of a hypocrite. In the second hadith we see there are four features of hadith of a munafiq. So al-hasru fi thalas. So there is no limitation in three. Or why it is limited to three in the first hadith? Because in the second hadith we see there are four. So why it is three and four like that? Then the reply or explanation for that. أجاب القرطبي باحتمال أنه استجد له صلى الله عليه وسلم من العلم بخصالهم ما لم يكن عنده. Imam Qurtubi's view is that, his explanation is that, what? أنه استجد. استجد means updated. Updated. So Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم updated the features of hypocrites with the four second hadith. Because he had no knowledge of those features when he was using the or mentioning the first hadith. So when he got knowledge about other features, he updated the features in the second hadith. So in the second hadith there are mentioned four features of the hypocrite. Okay, so in the first hadith three features, in the second hadith four features. So when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the second first hadith, he was not aware of the features mentioned or the additional features mentioned in the second hadith. Okay, that is the explanation given by Imam Qurtubi. Now waqulu, but I say, who say?
Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani.
Yes, very good. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani say, because this is Fathul Bari of Sahih al-Bukhari. That is, for Sahih al-Bukhari there are many explanatory kitabs, and out of those explanatory or sharh kitabs, one important one is what? Fathul al Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. So there we see, I say means Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani say, that is the explanation. Laysa bayn al-hadithayn ta'arud. Say, between these two hadiths, there is no opposition. They are not antagonistic. Okay, they are not opposing to each other. But what? لأنه لا يلزم من عد الخصلة المضمومة الدالة على كمال النفاق كونها علامة على النفاق لاحتمال أنه العلامات دالات على أصل النفاق والخصلة الزائدة إذا أضيفت إلى ذلك